Street Smoker Joe's again. Look, I know this COVID-19's got everybody self-quarantined and down and such like that. So I'm trying to make some lemonade out of these lemons, right? So that's right. Nothing ever going to keep us down. So this affords me the opportunity to do something I haven't done before, but that is to do an unboxing video. And this is going to be on the Masterbuilt 560 Gravity Series Charcoal Smoker. We'll get more into the smoker later. But I've already put one together. I've got to put one together for one of our customers. Yes, that's what we do here. We offer the free assembly and delivery as well. So I'm fixing to do an unboxing video. And I decided to do this after the first one that I did. The instructions are not so straightforward. Awesome product, horrible instructions. So hopefully if you decide to buy a Masterbuilt Gravity Fed 560, and soon to come out the 1050, then hopefully this will help you. So without further ado, let's get it on. Well, when you first get them in, obviously you're going to be in a box, but I found out there's a real easy way to go ahead and get all this stuff taken out. So let's start with that. All right. So all I did is took out the two straps. There's no reason to even untape the box at all. Let me show you why. Just comes right out. So all I do now is go ahead and get all this unpackaged. You do want to save your boxes and stuff because you want to use that to be able to lay it down so you don't scratch it up. Especially since this material is for a customer, we want to be as pretty as possible. So what I'm gonna do now is just go ahead, get all this unboxed and laid out. I know it's a pain in the butt, but trust me, you get everything laid out and separated, it makes it a lot easier. So next time you see me, I'll have all this laid out for you. Be right back. So you get everything stripped down, and this is the bottom. This is the bottom of the box that came in. Styrofoam still around it. Let me show you what all was in here. So just kind of wanted to show you everything that was contained in this box. Look at all the packing material. So they ship it quite well. A little bit of cardboard over here, but as you can see, it's really not a bunch of small things, right? Kind of some big parts. And then over here, always want to make sure you get your manual out just in case. Of course, you need it. And this right here is a hardware pack that they include. Do yourself a favor, flip it over because they got the letters, corresponding screws, and that's really all you need. All right, so I'm going to go step by step by the instructions as well as show you some things I found during the first one. First thing is, you notice I took that box top, I just cut it. Open it up, and that's the base box that still came in. First thing it says we need to do is go in behind here. We need to remove this tray. Comes right out that back there. That's your little grease trap. It's right there. Just took it out, put it up against the wall. Next thing we need to do is we need to go ahead and affix the latch handle here to the top of the charcoal hopper. Okay? We do not want to put this handle on. Don't make that mistake because it can break real easily. So, make sure to put this on next. Found this bag here. That's the knob that goes on front that you do not want to replace. This is going to be the little latch. It's pretty well straightforward. We just need four of the B screws. And that's why I said do it like this. What I do is I'm going to cut it down the back here. And I'll be able to see that these are B's. I'm going to take four of these little fellas out and put that latch on. All right, so I took the four B screws. Here, I'll show you. Right out of there. Took those four B screws. And it's pretty straightforward. Just right here, as you can see, there's two on that side, two over on this side. Just screwed it on like that. And this little fella will flip up, and there you go. Okay, this next step, we're gonna put the fan blower at the bottom of the charcoal hopper. Now, this is where the instructions started getting a little crazy. Let me point out a few things. There is a felt gasket that's gonna go between this fan motor and this hopper. Well, you have to locate it, and they put it inside the hopper. They did on the first one, they did on this one. They put it inside the hopper. Now, what they're gonna say on the instructions is to use double-sided tape to put this right here, obviously, so it can stay up, right? I'm gonna show you that's not exactly necessary. Okay, so you will get the fan assembly as such, okay? If you notice here, I have the felt gasket on there. It's gonna ask you to go ahead and put two A screws right here. No, I'm not being ugly, they're nice screws. Two A screws here. And see these right here? This little slot. What we're gonna do is gonna take that and we're gonna slide it in this way. But let me, a little secret I found, get these as close as you can as possible and you still slide behind it, because it is a bear to try to tighten them up when that step comes along. And if you notice, you don't need the double-sided tape. Those two screws hold that up nicely. Just when you go in to put it in, just do some slight adjustments, make sure all the holes are square, and go away. So, oh, another little thing. And this was confusing as all get out. This piece right here, okay? You'll see what it's for later. But they say you need to bend this out, but be careful. And you do have to be careful, because you've bent it enough times, it is going to snap. But what they want you to do is just take this and you bend this up to a 90 degree like that, okay? That's all you do there. Okay, yeah, so I forgot about this part. So as you can see, we got those, and they had to slide right in there, all right? So then we're gonna go ahead and do screw here, this one up top, and this one in the middle, all five. The one in the back we'll get later and set it up. But this is something that they didn't account for in the instructions. Right here. You see, these screws hold on this heat shield, right? And this right here needs to go in here. But they don't say anything about it, so I took it upon myself to try to do what was sensible, and that's to put it in there. So what I did is I went ahead and loosened up these screws right here and tucked this under it. I keep showing this because, you know, it's important to get this gasket right. So I took out the two little screws from here. You can see what I did is I just barely eased this in, this hopper here, in behind it. Okay, I didn't go all the way yet. Let me show you why. Because what I did is it gave me the opportunity to take this gasket when it's loose and arrange it to where, see, now we can go ahead and put the gasket in. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna replace this screw here first with one of the larger A screws and put it in there first to kind of help hold that in place. And then I'll go ahead and I'll take this and push it all up in there and then secure it all the way around. All right, so there we go. We got them all in. What I did is once I started this top center one here, I just took these right here and tightened them down and let it gradually pull itself in. No way I could cage where these holes were. And then install those. Now you can see it's a nice clean finish. That bottom, let's see. That bottom screw there, this top screw, that middle screw is all now tight. Well, let me show you why I wanted you to get these as close as possible. You see this right here? See the stretch you gotta try to make to get to it? So the least amount of turns you can make on this screw and the one on the bottom, the very first one you put in the screw into, or to slide it into, the better. That's why you need to get it as close as possible, just to save yourself some aggravation. All right, legs are next. Don't let this fool you. I'm gonna show you this. It's pretty straightforward. You can see the corner mounts there, right? Of course, as always, don't tighten them up all the way, because you got braces. We need to go in between them, so we need some movement. So don't tighten them up all the way. And also, I'm gonna point out, see these wires? You gotta remember, this is a sophisticated piece of equipment. So be sure to be mindful of where those are at all time. Try not to get hung up on them, you know, rip them out or anything. Enough about that. But what I want to show you, there's two types of legs. You see, you've got these right here. It's got the little space in them, right? A little gap. Okay, these are going to go on the top, there and there. These are going to go on the top. These two are cut at straight 90s. You see that? There's no little space in the corners. Those are straight 90s. They're going to go on the bottom there and there. So that's pretty straightforward, right? But here's where it can get you. It's because they'll fit anywhere. You see these little holes here and those holes there in these legs? Those need to go on the hopper side of the grill, okay? Again, 90 degrees go on the bottom. The ones with the spaces in the corners are gonna go on top. And then the two legs on the right side or the hopper side that have these holes in them, okay? They're gonna go on that right side And these two, as you can see over here, are just solid metal. So let me go ahead and get these put on. And also, it shows only to put these three corner legs on here, not the one up here. Don't put that one on yet. Well, I found that I didn't see a need, or not to. In fact, it caused me much more aggravation. So I'm gonna go ahead and loosely install all four of these legs. Okay, so the legs are on, they're loosely installed. Next thing we need to do is we need to put in this bottom rack here, and it's gonna go right here, and these bottoms here, and you'll see why when you put this in, it needs to be loosely installed. All right, so you can see, we got these put in. Just a couple of things I want to point out. I know it probably goes without saying, but make sure that the A-bolt goes in from the outside going in, from the outside going in. And I've neglected to say, on the back side, we're going to secure them with these D-nuts right here. All right, keep jokes to yourself. But here's a great thing, is that you do not have to have any type of wrench to hold that. They've got the little teeth on the back of it that's going to grab it whenever you tighten up, so it'll self-tighten. And also, on these back legs, know that these holes here and here are going to be for the axle, for the tires. So do not try to install them there. The mounting holes are above them, obviously. All right, got those tightened up. Next is, we're going to use this piece right here, okay? You see this hole here? It's going to be oriented to the front side, okay? So there's your grill. There's the hole. It's going to sit like that. These little cleats right here, that's what the holes were here and here in these legs. And they're just going to simply snap right in there. So let me go ahead and get that put in there. All right, so that's what it's going to look like. Now, in order to just clip in little holes, in order to mount it, you're going to need four A bolts and four D nuts. And you're going to have one here inside the hopper and the one on the other side. So show you that here in a minute. Okay, so that's it all buttoned up. You got the fan blower and everything buttoned up to that little cross member as well. Okay, next, in the instructions, the next step says that when you want to put that last leg on, one we were talking about earlier, when you put this on. But as you can see, that there was no need to do that if you left them all loose. Ah, brings my next part. Don't forget, your legs are loose. At this point here, you can go ahead and tighten those up, because as soon as we tighten those up, we're going to put the wheels on. So let's do that next. Okay, so all the legs are tightened up. Wheels are ready to go. The caster wheels are going to go in the front. As you can see, that you've got the places for them to go. And then this axle and these wheels are going to go through here. Here's something I ran into the first time. As you can tell, I had it laid down to do the bottom rack. These right here are not tightened up yet because of the way it's sitting. So we want to make sure you go ahead and get those tightened up, because when you put the wheel on the other side, it's going to block it. And that way you won't be able to get a screwdriver in there to be able to tighten them up. So we want to do those first. And also, again, probably goes without saying, there's a front and a back. You definitely want this side right here to the inside. You don't want your cart looking like that. Can't be rolling on that. You need to roll on some dubs. So you want to look just like that. Okay, so here's a pro tip to try to get these as snug and tight as possible. Get you a good pair of channel locks here. Vice grips. And what I do, because you're not really going to hurt the threads, just if you just clamp on these lightly and just give it a nice little tug down, then that will tighten up these casters enough to where they won't swivel out. Because there's no way to get down in here to turn this. And as you can tell, casters turn, and you don't want to grip onto here where the bearings are. But if you clip onto here just ever so gently, just enough to give it a nice little tug down, and that'll be enough to hold that caster on there, and you won't damage the threads enough that if you ever need to pull them out and replace them, you can't do that. Just a little pro tip for you, but be very careful. Proceed with caution. All right, so another little pro tip on this axle. You see this right here? That's like a finished side, right? And over here, it's going to have a nut. Now, this may just be me and just may be our company, but the way we like to do it is we want this nut facing on the back side of the grill, because all your guests and your family and friends are going to see the front side. So you definitely want that right there showing in the center hub of that wheel. So make sure that you put this part, just for aesthetic reasons, to the front side. So now we're just going to just go ahead and thread this through and get the back wheels on. Another pro tip on putting this axle in is when you get ready to tighten it up on the back side, if you take your pair of the vice grips there, and if you go to the underside of the cage here and clamp onto that axle, then when as you're turning the nut, it'll hold that axle as the wrench holds it against the ground. You want to snug it up to where there's really just a little bit of space or no space on each side. You can tell we got a little bit of space there. That's so it can still roll freely but not wobble. All right, so we come on the back side of it, and don't forget, we've got another screw here on this hopper. What held that gasket in right there? There's one right here in the middle that we need to do. Remember, this was laying on the ground. So once we get it stood up, we need to go ahead and put that one right there. It's just gonna be one of these A-bolts. I'll tell you what, A-bolts, D-nuts, I'll tell you, a sense of humor they do. Okay, now comes the electrical components of it. We got these wires here that's bundled up. You got your wires down here, right? We'll make sure these are good and connected, you know, and nothing coming through shipping. And then we got them sticking out here, but if you come up under here to where the fan is, right? And then coming off the grill itself, where are they? There. You've got these three. Okay, try to get them in focus for you. Okay, so these two hanging down, they're tied up. And this one here, okay, we're gonna take this down, and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with them. Okay, so I took the twist off that up there, and this is coming down here, right? This igniter wire here was twist tied to this one up in here. So this comes from the fan. This comes from the outside. We just thread through that hole right there, okay? And they're all going to hook in to this, these three. A couple of things from the first time. You want to retain your twist ties that you took off. Keep those. And this right here, because you're going to tie it up, this right here, this is not where a twist tie goes in to help hold these in. I thought they're going to be cute on the first one, thought that's what it's for. It's going to be used for something a little bit later. So we're going to get these plugged in, and I'll show you that in just a sec. All right, so which wires go to what, right? Let me get this into focus. Well, coming from the fan blower, if you can look, it's a red and a black, and there's a red and black coming off of the grill itself. Those two will go together. What it is you've got two little teeth in there, and you've got two little holes in there. Now, they're shaded, if you can see, they're kind of towards the bottom, right? Not exactly in the middle. Just line those up and click them together. Just push firmly, you hear them click, and they're attached. And you go, voila, just that easy. The other two, they're exactly the same. You just click them in. But that red and black lead coming off, it's going to go to the red and black for that fan. Obviously, that's going to be pulling the most juice to get that nice and hot. All right, so let's see if I can show you what went on here. So the wires and everything that we took, what I did is this one right here is already there from the factory. Okay, holding up the main power cord here, is I just twist tied behind it there, and then I came up and I twist tied it once again on up from there in order to have these be out of the way. Because then when you look at it from out front, no wires to be seen. All right, next we're gonna get this piece here. It's a cover, okay? We'll get two B screws, which I'm using my small Phillips for. What we're going to do is we're going to take these right on front. Remember those wires? We're going to take care of that problem. Take those on front. We're going to loosen this one and this one. And this will then tuck up behind there like that. Okay? And that's the little piece that we bent. Remember very first on the hopper? We bent out. There it is sitting right there. Well, guess which hole that's going to go through? Right there. That's right. Okay, so that's what it looks like once it's on. Nice and covered up. We got that little part we bent out.
through that little hole. You got space for a door latch,
and everything's tucked in nicely. I'll tell you people, so right here we're gonna have a little discussion with your Masterbuilt, because she does not want to cooperate too well trying to put that on, but it will go with enough determination. This right here is gonna be on the back piece. Let's come around here to the back, put it right there. We'll go ahead and get her buttoned up. All right, so now we got the back all in. So we got it shielded all the way around, right? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna work on this part. The door, this right here is gonna be the grate that is going to hold back the charcoal. It's just simply gonna slide up in there. And of course we got our ash bucket that will just simply sit in there. And then the door. So let's get all this put together. All right, assembly is pretty well straightforward. It's just slides and racks. Goes with this this lip right here. Goes this lip down. And the bucket, if you look, it's actually curved on one end and straight on the other. So it fits in there just like a puzzle. See how it sits in there like that. Try to do it backwards. It's not gonna work. Obviously, it's gonna hang out. So, again, won't be able to shut the door. It's pretty simple. Goes in here, and then this door is just simply gonna do what we've seen on other grills. Just gonna hinge, the fan's gonna hang right in there. All right, so door's on there. Latch is already installed, that you need to do there. At the very beginning, we push this thing out here, right, remember? Now we're gonna see what those are for. They're gonna be for our dampeners here. You got a fat one, or a large one, or a long one, and one just the opposite. This one will go up top. Slide in. Well, I'm trying to do it one-handed. Let's see if I can. There we go. See how they fit and slide right in there like that. Get the other one in. So there they are, slid in place. Real simple. This is gonna go up here on your hopper lid for your handle. Next is gonna be the assembly of the thermostat and the handle for the lid. So you need the bar, those two end pieces, the thermostat, which already has all the hardware with it, and then you're gonna need your ease out of your tool kit. Now it's gonna come with two different washers, a lock washer and a flat washer. The assembly is the bolt with the lock washer first, and then the flat washer next to press against the lid. Similar to this, pretty straightforward. Right there, you've got a little notch there at the bottom. And if you see that little notch right there in the bottom of the thermostat, that's gonna go right in there. That will ensure that it's centered properly. And then underneath, be careful not to go too far, you've got, oops. These, washer first, then the wing nut, and just hand tight. All right, so now that's attached. Now it's time for the handles. A little something about the handles. You've got one bolt that holds it on. And it's very easy to put them on upside down. Upside down would be with it angling up like this. You want to make sure that it's angled down this way. If not, your handle will be upside down. And when you go to lift up the lid, the handle will be too far away to grab it to pull it back down. Another easy way to remember it is, you see how this is shaped down like a wedge? Well, see, that's also shaped down like a wedge. So the small part at the bottom, wide part at the top, and you can't go wrong. All right, so this is going to be kind of difficult to show, but there is underneath a little hole there. What I've done is I just went in and put the bolt on my screwdriver. And I'm holding it up, as you can see, like this. And then I'm going to just partially screw it in there enough to hold it on, because I've also got to hold up the lid. So this is a pretty tricky part. Again, mine will have a discussion with your grill. All right, so I got it loosely in there, because if you drop that screw and it goes, it will go inside this entire lid. So as you can see, it's on there. It's just loose. That's why we want it. Now comes the fun part. All right, so as Shoney's out there calling the dog, inside, if you notice right here, there's a notch on this, and inside here, I don't know if you can see it, there's a little notch in there. There's a line up that keeps it from spinning, right? So let's try to assemble this. You can assemble both ends and then put them in there and try to do it down. Just not going to work. So you got to pull this one here because you want it loose. Right? Put them on the lock casters. We'll stop spinning on them. It looks worse than it really is. Not really. So again, it's nice to have a magnetized tip. Here, carefully, click, ta-da, and then spin this little filler around, it'll go right here, and you're almost home. Let's get this little bad boy started like that, okay? Again, not to over-tighten. That was spun on me. No big deal. I'm just going to reverse the process. Just remain calm. Everything's going to be all right. See? Just remain calm. Remember, the grill is your friend. It's not out to get you. Again, just snug. Don't be an over tightener. Yeah. Voila, go to the next step. All right, the next step, we're gonna take these two. These are gonna be new ones, or C's. Okay, there's only two of them. And we're gonna screw them in this piece here. Okay, and we're gonna screw them in here, but, and you'll see why they're going to act as hangers here in a minute. What this is going to do, these two slots here, this is your charcoal box, right? And as you can see, it's already got, that's just the grease they ship it in. That's normally everything. These right here are going to slide into these holes and then move forward. And that hole, that end, is going to be a perfect match for that right there, which feeds the charcoal through. So let's go ahead and get that started. All right, so as the dogs frolic and play, what I did is I went ahead and installed these in right here, okay? And you see, they go right in here, and they slide down, okay? There they are in the back. Oops, get my finger out of the way. So what I did is I tightened these up to where I couldn't pull it out and backed them off just a little bit, and let me show you why. Because I found that it's easier. The instructions say to install this in there and then install that on top of here, and you got to try to get under it and do this and that. What I found out to try to match up the holes is go ahead and pre-assemble it and then put it in. And I'm trying to hold the camera to show you how to do that. All right, so there's the whole thing buttoned up. You see the little shelf there, lip up, right? Makes a little tray. And then the box itself set on there, the set screws that we showed you, and just simply slid forward into that receptacle there. And what I do is I come back here and tighten these back up just because it is holding up the charcoal box. We want to make sure this stays put. All right, next step is going to be the controller unit here. All we're going to do in this step is we're just going to take the Bluetooth Wi-Fi antenna here. We're going to screw it into there, and we're going to have it pointing up, which is really going to be down when we flip it over. Okay, the left side or opposite end that we've been working on, we're going to put this onto here. So if you look at the top, which is the bottom because it's upside down, you got the slotted ones, right? That means we're going to use those two gold holes on those two here. We're going to go ahead and install the top two part way. So that way we can hang this shelf. All right, now we got the shelf put on. What we're going to do now is just few little finishing touches. We'll get those wires in a minute. We'll put that ash pan or the grease pan back in the back. First thing we took out. And all we're gonna do now is put our ash pan in the bottom and grates inside. So let's come back and do that. All right, so we got the grates on there. It's pretty cool. This end over here, smoke, because where the less heat is. This over here says sear, So, and then in the middle, of course, would be your barbecuing and your grilling. That's pretty cool. All right, and so we just put the back in.
Right, and then you see the pan goes in that that drip pan and stuff like that. So all that just kind of goes together pretty easy.
Now under here is where we're gonna do electronic work. So we get a little light on this. This right here is gonna be your heat shield, right? You want your heat shield to absolutely protect your control box here. And we've got three hookups here, and we got three hookups here, but it looks like we don't have, I mean, we got one not enough, because this one right here is going to plug in right up in there. Now, there is a right and wrong way to do it. There's a positive and there's a negative. If you can see, maybe you can't, one's a little bit wider than the other. It will only go in that one way. So if we say we try to plug it in like this, see, it's not doing anything. We turn around and try to plug it in. Try to do both things at once. I think it's easy to hold this and film at the same time. There. Now, it only go in one way. It won't go in another way. These two right here will fit those two. And this right here is going to be your plug-in. So we're just going to snap those together. All right, so that's how they all will be hooked up. You can see, just kind of put them up in there. You got your heat shield right there protecting this. These are thermally coated through here. And you see that white and black? Maybe I can show you. Anyway, if you were to pull this back, I mean red and black, you pull this back, there's red and black in here. Hook those two together just like we did on the fan, the other ones, and this here. Light off here. So you can tell you got your probes and things here. It's gonna come with one probe. Of course, you can buy more. And this right here is your access port right there for your probe to go in. And where's it at? There it is. And then out here, and then into your grill. The last thing to do was to hook up your power cord. It goes into here. Now there are little, I didn't show it, it's pretty self-explanatory. There are little, you know, tits on there that you push it in there, and then you twist it to lock it. And that way it has a sure fit there. All right, so that's just what we did. That's what we got built. That's what we got put together. It is a very, very nice machine. Comes with all the standard aggravations of everything else. Maybe in the future do a how-to video. But let's sum this up. All right, so that's the kind of long and short of it, just a few things. Don't get frustrated, don't get mad. Just take your time with it, it will come together. Consider it part of the enjoyment. Always use hand tools. Never use more than, you know, what the good Lord gave you. Anything else, you can start stripping out bolts, tightening down things. There's, you know, some of the part of the metals are flimsy. You can get those dented and just, you know, it might not affect it functionally, but you want it to look good. So now what I'm going to do for my customer is I'm going there now, give it a final run through, give it a final wipe down, clean up everything. You know, get it nice and polished and shined up, get all the packing, grease and things off of certain stuff, and give him a call and let him know that I'm ready to deliver it whenever he is. Look, really appreciate you watching this unboxing video. Let me know what you think about it. Could we do better? You want to see another one? Do you not want to see one? Because we're always getting new grills in here at Sweet Smokey Joe's Outdoor Emporium and putting them together. So why not just let us do the work for you, right? Look, I really appreciate y'all watching. Remember, we're all in this thing together, this COVID-19 thing going on. So, hey, look, we're going to pull through this stronger than ever before. Remember the three rules. This is the order they need to be in: God, family, and friends. You keep that in your perspective, everything's going to be just fine. So, thanks again for watching. Sweet Smokey Joe's. How about that? I get no